Hello, everyone. Today we are going to be running through five total documents that need to be made accessible. Some of them are scanned images, so I thought I would run them through Abby and get them ready to make accessible. I have launched Abby FindReader PDF 15, and my first step is to select Open in OCR Editor. Now from here, I'm going to select the five files that I want to open. And they all are going to be imported at the same time. So I have 133 pages. This is somewhat useful for when you're just in the flow of working. This makes it a little bit easier so you don't have to like open one file and edit. I'm just gonna do it all at one time. So when you first import all of the pages, the first thing that we want to do, I want to recognize these files as English language. So it is going to run OCR on all 113 pages. I did pause the video for a moment. It took about another 30 seconds or so. And what we're going to begin doing is basically matching our text pane with our image pane. And I want to make sure that the content mostly matches. Now for my accessibility purposes, I'm actually going to remove some of the information. For example, this image field, I'm going to delete it as it doesn't provide me any additional context from an accessibility perspective. So for me, I'm just going to simply delete it and it won't be exported out when I go to do my export. So what I'm doing now is I'm just briefly validating that the content in the text panel matches the content in the image pane over on the left. And it looks pretty good. Now I'm just going to walk through this. I'm going to select page two and validate just visually. Does all of this content make sense? It looks good. It doesn't appear to be any errors on the text panel, and we're just going to keep on moving. Now, again, for my accessibility purposes, I am deleting a couple of these text fields on the bottom. This is an accessibility guideline to remove repetitive content, as we don't want it to disrupt the flow of our paragraphs. So when I hit delete on those fields, they are no longer here in the text panel. I'm gonna move to page five. Now, something to note, let's say that our scan wasn't doing very good and maybe we had a bunch of gobbledygook over here, a bunch of X's or whatever. Sometimes this happens when converting. So what we can do, we can actually change the PDF recognition mode. Now to do that, I'm simply going to change it from use OCR to automatically choose between OCR and text from PDF, or use only the text from the PDF. Let's try this other option, and then we're going to select recognize page. We just want to scan this individual page. All right. So the results look pretty similar. Nothing too groundbreaking over here. Sometimes this really matters though. Again, I'm going to change this back to OCR for my other pages, and we're just going to keep on moving. Now, there is another option. So right now, I am deleting this content on the bottom, the footer. There is another option, but I've had mixed results with it. Now, when we go to actually export our file out, we have the ability to select or deselect, keep headers and footers and pictures. I've had mixed results with this, so I like to just remove them right out of the get-go. And let's keep going. We're going to delete a couple of those footers. we're just going to work through this. Looks like we have a table here. We're going to try to tackle this table once more. So I'm going to grab my table tool from my options here, and it says draw table area. I'm just going to drag a box around the contents, and Abby has a cool feature when you're using that table function to analyze the table structure automatically. And it's pretty accurate. There's some cases where you may want to manually add these columns and rows, but for now, this came through perfect. And then whenever we add a new field, we actually need to reorder the content, or at least from an accessibility perspective, that's what I'm going to do now. So I'm going to select the Reorder Areas button, and I'm simply going to select each field as it appears on the screen. And it's very hard to see, but there is a little number at the top of each of these zones. So we've got a 1 here, a 2, a 3, it's very hard to see, and a 4. And we're just going to keep on going. So because this was a scanned image, we actually have some text up here that is coming through kind of funky. So we're just going to do our best to fix it. It looks like a typo. So that, yeah, this, pretty terrible here. But we're going to do our best to fix it. And move on. Sometimes this happens. This file is from, I think, the 1980s, and it was a scanned document. So that's why some of our issues here. Now, this is the start of a new document, but it's the same working file. So what I'm going to actually do right now, I'm going to save my project, and I'm just going to throw them on the desktop. I'm going to save the whole project, and it creates a single file for this whole project. But what if I wanted to create a Word document out of the files we just did? I can actually change my save option to save as Microsoft Word, and I'm going to change this drop-down option to create a separate file for each source file. And then I'm going to save this to my desktop. Now this should create 5 separate Microsoft Word documents that I could then open individually and make changes to. And it looks like they appeared. Let's open up our first document. It was a smaller file. I am going to work on the rest of these, but I want to show you what it actually comes through as. So right now, this is coming through as text boxes, which is pretty terrible for a screen reader to use. So I'm actually going to export this out differently. So I'm going to close that file. And on my save options, I'm going to change it from exact copy to editable copy. And then we're going to hit the save button again and kind of do the same process again. I'm going to overwrite all 5 of my files, and this is with the style of editable copy versus exact copy. All right. We now have a document that has headings in it. The headings actually came through, and all of our text looks pretty clean for the most part. We kind of have some weird font issues here, but this is based off of the source document. And again, this was a really old document from many, many years ago that was scanned. Hey, our table came through nice. And this is really a good looking document for the most part. Just for fun, let's run our check accessibility on it. Looks like our reading order on the table needs a little bit of fixing. But yeah, this is a nice looking document that came out of Abby into Word. So this is just one example. My plan is to post more of these videos. So if you liked this, please drop a comment, let me know. Thanks, guys.